Today, I have resigned as Minister of Finance, along with other Cabinet Ministers. I hope this episode will open a new chapter towards a more stable Malaysian administration, so that 100% focus could be given to efforts to address the challenges of COVID-19. The last 18 months have been really tough and challenging. Like all countries in the world affected by COVID-19, all strategies and plans have been focused on saving the lives and livelihoods of the people and ensuring the economy remains stable. However, the country's political situation and limited fiscal space have further complicated an already complex task to balance our rakyat's safety, their source of income, and to help our economy survive. But in making any policy decisions, the topmost agenda for the MOF team and for me has always been the well-being of the people. I would like to take this opportunity to thank all MOF staff who have worked so hard to help our rakyat. As someone from the corporate world, I'm truly impressed with the commitment of our civil servants in executing one of the country's biggest responsibilities, pushing through policies and reforms through these tough times. They have worked really hard, sometimes with many having to spend long days and nights at the office to craft the various packages and manage the country's finances, more so in these very challenging times. It is this spirit of partnership and cooperation that has enabled MOF to create and implement the many policies, measures, financial aid and stimulus packages against the constraints of time and resources. For instance, Budget 2021, which is the biggest national budget in Malaysian history, as well as the 8 economic stimulus packages. One of MOF's achievements that I hope will continue is the elevated level of transparency in the formulation and implementation of policies, packages and future budgets. We had, for instance, established for the first time in MOF history an agency for tracking and monitoring, that is Laksana. Since last year, over 16 Laksana reports have been issued for the rakyat to evaluate the implementation of the various packages that the government had introduced. Transparency is further complemented by a spirit of inclusiveness, opening our MOF doors to members of the public and industry, and even welcomed opposition parties to meet and discuss on policies and measures. Never before had so many opposition members stepped through MOF doors to share their views and ideas before major announcements such as the national budget or the national recovery plan. I hope all the policies created and the momentum of recovery we have achieved to date will continue under the new administration. We cannot let this hard-earned recovery momentum go to waste. The recovery cannot be derailed for the sake of our nation, for the sake of our rakyat. Ladies and gentlemen, as mere mortals, we can only plan to give our best. But it is God who decides. Man proposes, and the Almighty disposes. My sincere thanks to Yang Amat Berhormat Prime Minister Tan Sri Muhyiddin Yassin for trusting me to be in his cabinet. Serving as the Minister of Finance is the highlight of my career. It is very challenging, but it has been my greatest honour and privilege to be given this opportunity to serve the country. I admit I'm not perfect. Although I have tried my best, there is still room for improvement. I did my job to the best of my ability, but history will be the better judge. I would like to apologize for all the shortcomings during my tenure. May we survive the ongoing instability and strife. Hopefully, the people will continue to persevere until our fight against COVID-19 ends in absolute victory. Salam terakhir saya dari Kementerian Kewangan. Thank you and stay safe. My prayers for our rakyat. May God bless our beloved nation.